Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 8 of Java and Web, Modular Programming in Java. In this video, we will learn about module source path and module path options in Java C. In the directory src, we have stored source codes of two modules, the module mod A and the module use module. Let's see the source code of the module use module. Open moduleinfo.java. The module use module requires the module mod A. Let's go in the package directory up. Inside package directory up, we have usepack.java. Let's open it. The usepack.java imports the class a1 from the package pack1. The method main of the class usepack is printing the string usepack. After that, it creates an object of type a1. And finally, it's calling the method print on an object whose address is stored into the reference variable a1. The package pack1 belongs to the module mod A. Let's go in the module directory mod A. In the module directory mod A, we have moduleinfo.java. Let's open it. Moduleinfo.java requires another module, the module mod B. And moduleinfo.java exports the package pack1. Let's go in the package directory pack1 in the module mod A. The package directory pack1 contains a1.java. Let's open it. a1.java imports a class a2 from the package pack2. The public class a1 contains a public method print which returns void. The first statement in the method print prints the string pack1.a1. Then after the method print creates an object of type a2. And finally it's calling the method print on an object whose address is stored into the reference variable a2. But the problem is that the package pack2 is stored into the module mod b. And in the source directory we do not have any module whose name is mod b. You can see here, we do not have source code of any module whose name is mod b. The module mod b is actually present on the desktop as compiled code in the directory other module. Here is the compiled code of the module mod b. If you go inside the directory, you can see here we have moduleinfo.class. So this is the compiled code of the module mod b. That's how we need to compile a source code of a module which is using another compiled module. That's how we need to compile source codes of these two modules. But the source code of module mod A is using the compiled code of another module mod B. For that we need to execute the Java C command and followed by option M of the Java C command we need to provide the names of two modules which we want to compile. We want to compile only two modules, the module mod A and the module use module. The module mod B is already compiled, we do not have to compile it. So followed by the option M, we need to provide names of only those modules which we need to compile. Then after we have two another options. First option is module source path and another option is module path. Followed by the option module source path, we need to provide name of that directory which contains source codes of two modules. And followed by the option module path, we need to provide name of that directory which contains compiled codes of modules which are used by these two modules. Followed by the option D, we need to provide name of that directory which contains the compiled code of these two modules. So the compiled code of modules whose names are followed by the option M will be stored into the directory out. Press enter. It compiles fine. And you can see here the directory out has been created on the desktop. Inside the directory out, we have compiled code of two modules, the module mod A and the module use module. These two are compiled codes. The directory out does not contain the compiled code of the module mod B. Now let's execute the class usepack which is present in the package up. We are going to run a class which is present in the module use module. Other option of Java command is module path. Followed by module path, we need to provide names of two directories which contains compiled code of various modules. The names of two directories are separated by colon in Linux and semicolon in Windows. The directory out contains the compiled code of modules, the module mod A and the module use module. And the directory other module contains the compiled code of the module mod B. Press enter. It executes fine and printing usepack pack1.a1 and pack2.a2. So this is how we differentiate between the options module source path and module path in Java C command. Followed by the option module source path, we have names of the directories which contains source codes of various modules. But followed by the option module path, we have names of the directories which contains compiled codes of various modules. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe this channel if you are new, and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.